Wide bandwidth is something that is historic with Rupert's designs, that he had pursued that early on in his consoles to have, you know, flat frequency response out, you know, beyond 80 kilohertz. And on the low end, too, it's actually as important or more important than the low frequency. Most of our designs, the circuits will perform down to below 1 hertz. And we try to stay flat to 10 hertz or lower. In the upper frequencies, even though the higher frequencies above 20 or 22 kilohertz are outside of the hearing range of humans, they still have an impact, as we've experienced in multiple sessions of listening, that there's an impact of the overtones and the harmonics that occur above 20 kilohertz. And maintaining flat frequency response from, as I said, below 10 hertz to a minimum of 50 kilohertz up to 80 kilohertz is really become important in the sonic characteristics of the finished product. And listening tests in-house and experiences of users have proven that over the years.
Extended bandwidth has always been one of the things that Rupert had rallied for. This goes back over 25 years. Initially, this came from his interactions with Jeff Emmerich, where Jeff had spotted an issue with one of the vintage Neve consoles in Air Montserrat that was generating an anomaly at 53 kilohertz. At first, Rupert was dubious, but then Jeff showed him what he was actually hearing and how to listen for this. He also read a number of the reports, like from Dr. Ohashi in Japan, that clearly said that although we can't hear tone after 20 kilohertz, we certainly perceive it, and it has some impact on what happens down in the audible band.
So what we try and maintain is a frequency response curve that does roll off at about 1 hertz, so we pull out all the subsonic stuff as much as, you know, is reasonable. But we do want it going down there, like I said, flat to about 10 hertz. And on the high end, what we like to see is as flat as we can be, out to 80 kilohertz, then with a nice slow roll off to where we're approximately 3 dB down at 120. And that seems to be kind of the optimum range.